Okay, safety, just general safety anytime you're working around automobile and related equipment. First off, all the chemicals and everything and engine oil and anything to do with cars, all those chemicals, oils and solvents and everything are all carcinogens known to cause cancer. So you want to have some protection for your skin. I just use cheap latex gloves. Any type of the neoprene, latex, or nitrile gloves will work just fine. Some of the chemicals actually on the latex gloves can dissolve them relatively quickly, and the nitrile will work a little bit better for that. I just like the latex because they're thinner and easier to work with. Other things with safety is we're going to be jacking the vehicle, so you need to make sure that the vehicle is properly set up. It's in park, parking brake is set, and you're on a flat, level surface. You need to have a jack stand to hold the load of the vehicle. And anytime you're working around hand tools, power tools, safety glasses. I've got corrective lenses, so that's what I'll be wearing. Tools needed. Generally, I just use my standard basic Craftsman tool set. It's just got a good assortment of some basic sockets, standard and deep, in both metric and standard, and a small assortment of open and box end wrenches, some ratchet wrenches, pliers, screwdrivers, a couple extensions. You'll need the vehicle jack and a load-carrying device for the vehicle, jack stand, wood block, something of that nature, something to support the vehicle while you're working on it. We'll need a couple cans, or probably not that much, some type of cleaning solvent to clean the parts once we remove them for installing a new valve cover gasket. Other than the most important item, the feeler gauge for checking the clearance on the valves. So please watch our next segment on jacking the vehicle.